Having one home server node box is fun, but why stop at one? Today I'm going to be taking a look at setting up a cluster using three of these Ugreen NAS units, installing Proxmox and Ceph on it, getting some overall experience using it, and just having fun with this cluster. I have the opportunity to design or create quite a few kind of home lab and home server environments, and oftentimes I'm in a position where I could either choose to go with a small cluster like this or a single larger node. And oftentimes, I choose a single larger node. It's easier to troubleshoot, it's a simpler setup, there's less to possibly go wrong, but there's something fun and exciting I find about going with a cluster setup, and I really like working with them. So in this video, I'm gonna try to create what I like to think of as a practical cluster system while having a reasonably low amount of noise and power consumption, still being able to play with clusters, and I just kind of want to see how that solution works. I also want to note that this video is likely going to be the first part of kind of a series of working with this cluster, so I really want to take a look at other topics that you all might be interested in, like a cluster versus a single larger node, how does Proxmox's networking look like in terms of setting up maybe things like SDN with their solution between these nodes, storage and shared storage and how that works, and possibly looking at other software out there like Storage Spaces Direct, Nutanix, VMware, or other possible solutions with these boxes. So the first thing of creating any cluster is getting hardware that can make it work. And that's why I want to say a big thank you for Ugreen for sponsoring this video and providing these three NAS units as I used in this video. While these NAS units come with the Ugreen NAS OS that provides kind of a simple traditional NAS OS, it's really nice that they allow you to install other OSs on it and even work with people like me to make videos showing off that functionality. And I think they actually suit the situation pretty well here because these are all relatively low power boxes with a reasonable amount of hard drive bays as well as two M.2 drive bays and all of these systems hidden, and 10 gigabit networking in all of these boxes I have here today, so they can actually communicate and work reasonably well in a shared storage situation. And doing all of this while keeping power consumption and noise relatively low between all these boxes. So in this setup right here, I have this DX6800 Pro box, which is a 6-bay, also has a PCIe slot for putting in something like another SSD or network card, and two of these DXP4800 Plus units, which are 4-bay units with a bit slower of processors and only one 10 gig port and a 2.5 gigabit port, so they can all work together. One of the cool things of clusters is they're generally kind of flexible, depending on the exact software, with having multiple different boxes, CPUs, RAM amounts, and more. So it's going to be interesting to see how software handles that. The another big thing with clusters is setting up networking between these boxes. While technically any networking that connects all the boxes works, you almost need 10 gigabit or at least more than gigabit networking to start working with distributed storage in a practical matter, I would say these days. So that's where I want to say a big thank you to SeekStore, and believe I'm saying that correctly, for providing this managed 10 gigabit switch. This is a pretty compact little 10 gigabit switch with a reasonably quiet fan in it that allows me to have all these systems plugged in at 10 gigabit along with five other systems on a network at pretty high speeds, and is overall a nice little box. If you're interested in any of this equipment, check out the links in the video description. Let's get the cluster created now. I've done some basic setup on all of these nodes by installing Proxmox on them and updating the nodes, but I haven't made any of the cluster configuration yet. Luckily, Proxmox makes that really easy, so I can pretty easily go onto one of these nodes, make a cluster, call it something like Ugreen cluster, and just link all of these systems. As I said earlier, clusters get incredibly complex, but luckily I can pretty easily just copy this join information and start from here. And now that I've pasted the join information and used the join cluster command on both of these nodes, it should all be accessible in one system, and I can see all of my nodes, none of them have any VMs or anything set up on them, and I can just manage them all together. And this brings me to one interesting thing with clusters is you can really choose how much you want to cluster or something like this. In this most basic cluster, I can just do migrations and manage them together. And if you want to just do something really simple, Proxmox Data Center Manager might almost be a better solution, but I want one of his the more hyper-converged setup. So that essentially means each of these nodes has storage shroud on them as well as VMs. That's in replacement of kind of the more traditional setup of having a separate storage or NAS system and then having compute nodes that are completely separate. The advantage is all of these nodes are able to do both and I don't need a separate storage box somewhere. The disadvantage though is that storage requires some resources that it takes away from being able to potentially run more VMs on these boxes. But I think it's fun to kind of see them all work together on everything. So that's where Ceph comes in. It's able to do distributed storage, and because I have reasonably fast systems with SSDs and hard drives and a fast 10 gigabit switch, I want to see how well distributed storage works on kind of a semi-practical setup. For the last hour or so, I've been playing around with this cluster, installed a few test VMs, did some benchmarks, and overall just had a bit of fun with it. And I want to talk about the just fun factor that I find comes along with clusters later on. But first I want to talk about practicality. Is this a practical home server? Well, I guess when I think practical, I think, is it too obtrusive when it comes to noise? Is power cost going to be a big issue? And is troubleshooting it and just maintaining it going to be a major problem? Power consumption wise, I've had this whole system, so the three nodes as well as the switch, plugged into my power consumption meter. And in idle or the lowest loads, I'm at about 150 watts, about 180, 190 watts for everything. Like right now when I'm running a couple VMs at relatively low load. And then when I'm pushing Ceph and moving data around in some VMs, I'm at about 220, 230 watts. And certainly I can get a single node that uses quite a bit less power than that. But I do want to note that quite a bit of that power consumption, especially at idle, is coming from all of these 14 mechanical hard drive bays. And like any storage solution, fewer, bigger hard drives is gonna save you quite a bit of power, especially when the nodes are running at idle. Noise-wise, according to my Apple Watch, I've been basically always at under 50 decibels, so it's not silent, but it's not loud enough that I'd have a major issue with it. And if you want a newer silent setup, tuck this away in like a closet and you probably won't hear it at all. And cost-wise is always relative for everything. These newer, nicer nodes are certainly more expensive than what used systems would get you, but certainly more expensive what used systems get you, and you're definitely gonna need more hardware for a cluster than anything. But it's not that far off a single node that can fit 14 hard drives, and 10 gig is still having a price premium. So I'd say this fits under what my definition of a reasonable home server would be. I won't think it's that extraordinary getting something like this, and power and noise aren't that bad. So then, is it fun? And this is where I'm gonna give it a big yes. And I think one thing that's slightly underappreciated with home lab solutions is the fun factor and the learning and kind of the enjoyment of tweaking. While this certainly isn't for everyone, and some people want a simple solution that just works, I think clusters are really good for that, and if you're in it for the lab factor, where you can mess around with options, try different things, a cluster really gives you more in that regard. There's a lot more tweaking to go on here. I can add a fourth node, I can play around with HA a lot better with multiple nodes, and I think it's just fun. It's hard to describe it on its own, but it's just, I can play around with things and do it in a manner that actually isn't that unreasonable for a home server. So let's take a look at my screen and see what I like to say is fun. So first of all, if I have VMs running on this system, so for example, this Windows test VM, I can just migrate this to a different node and it's super fast and has essentially no downtime. Here's this Windows VM being migrated. All it has to do is copy the 4 gigabytes of RAM from the other node because Ceph is already accessible to all of the nodes right now. So it's migrated now and VNC has to reconnect. That VM has no idea what's going on, it didn't mind it, and it's working just fine. And as you can see on this VM right now, here's the virtual disk performance of my SSD-only Ceph setup. Read speeds aren't bad, random I/O queue depth isn't great, and writes aren't that great, but it's what I'd consider to be reasonable performance-wise, and especially for consumer-grade hardware with no tweaking, where you can probably get fast if you're willing to tweak and play with details. The other fun thing I like to point out with clusters, in my opinion, is that you can just pop out hardware and exchange things. My dream file storage solution is one where I can mix any hardware, any drives, and it just makes a big volume with whatever I'd like. And Ceph gets pretty close to that. I can just yank out one of these drives, and it's going to detect that the drive has failed in here. I can remove it from the pool. I could take maybe a bigger 8 terabyte drive and replace it to get more usable storage space. I can add an additional drive if I want. I can set up multiple volumes of maybe caching or parity-like setup so I can get more usable space, or I can have higher levels of redundancy. While Ceph certainly has a learning factor, it's probably up there in the most configurable storage options out there. Whereas something like ZFS is a lot more fixed in how you have to set up disks. It's awesome to see a solution where you can just yank disks and make your pool smaller if you want that, or add disks and make it bigger. So I see now, it sees my disks as being out, so I can just say out, and it's gonna go replicate data from the other two nodes onto the drives in this node, so the drive is like it never existed. I can put a new one in, or I could just run with one less drive, and it's not like RAID where it's a degraded setup. It's just fixing it to be normal with less drives now. The other thing I wanted to test is, how is the performance on all of these hard drive configurations? So what I've done for my hard drive testing performance setup is I've created a Debian VM with a 4 terabyte volume on the mechanical hard drives in this array, and then I made a Samba share and connected it to my test PC all over 10 gigabit networking. And if no tweaking, here's the performance I got. While I have certainly seen better performance, so 600 reads, 150 write, with no configuration, this isn't bad. Certainly more than enough for media playback and stuff like that, and is likely gonna scale if I wanted to add more disks or faster disks for a setup like this. Let me know if you agree with this mindset that I think clusters are just something fun about working with a cluster that traditional hardware doesn't show. And I think this setup shows that even with consumer grade hardware that isn't the best, you can definitely get enough performance where it is my definition of usable. And if you want to tweak it or play with it, you can kind of only go up from there in terms of performance. I'm also curious about my viewers. Are you running single nodes, clusters? Why did you pick that solution, and how is it working out for you? I'd love to hear that in the comments below. And I'd also love to hear, as I mentioned earlier, other thoughts of fun and exciting things you think I should do with this cluster. Thanks for watching this video, taking a look at the cluster at these Ugreen systems. Let me know in the comments below if that sounds like something fun you'd want to work with, or your thoughts on little clusters like this. I've also tried to set up YouTube membership, so check out the join button below if you want to see videos like these a little bit early, and a couple of behind the scenes videos and posts that I occasionally make.